the five things to help you sing better.
Number one.
Posture.
Well, I hope my introduction didn't scare you off. I have to confess that I'm having a good time making these little videos and experimenting. For that introduction, I used Audacity to edit the audio, and what I did was I duplicated tracks, and then I added different pitches, so that's why it sort of sounds like an alien. Right now I'm going to talk about posture. And just a little bit about the five things to help you sing better in general. I've been a mediocre singer most of my life. Actually, my singing voice has sounded like my speaking voice is it's sort of odd, you know. I mean, I can, you know, I listen to my recorded voice and it's sort of strange sounding. And I call people on the phone that I haven't seen for 20 or 30 years, and they know it's me right away. But after applying the five things to help you sing better, just being a music teacher and teaching those principles, eventually they started to work for me. When I was in college my senior year, I had a really, really great voice teacher. Mitch was the voice teacher that took everyone average and made them spectacular. Now, I didn't take lessons from him until just the end of my senior year, and it was sort of too late. Plus, I had every vocal problem in the book, from having been a young child who could not say R. That meant that I spoke in the back of my throat. I didn't project my sound out, and I also, my registers were messed up, so I could sing low notes and really, really high notes, and I couldn't sing notes in the middle. I had a break in my voice about at A and B. So it was a pretty great thing when in my mid-40s, all of a sudden, all of these principles started clicking for me, and my voice sounded much better. And eventually you'll hear me sing, but it's my singing voice is a lot better than my speaking voice. My speaking voice could be better if I applied all those principles, but I don't know. I think it's kind of too late for me for that. I don't know. And I don't care about it enough. But it sure is fun to sing better. If you apply the five things to help you sing better, you will have a singing voice that is the best it could possibly be. Your body is the instrument when you sing, and if you hold it in a certain position and do this and do that, it's just like playing a band instrument. If you hold it the right way and if you blow into it the right way and you press the right buttons, or I'm not a band teacher, but anyway, you know, you hold down the right keys, you're going to have a great sound. It's the same thing for singing. So we will learn the five things to help you sing better, plus we will also learn diction. It's very important you know how to enunciate correctly. But anyway, back to the five things to help you sing better. Number one is posture. And posture is directly connected to number two, which will be breathing. There are four different illustrations we're going to look at to examine posture. The first two are the wrong way, and the second two are the correct way. The first one that we see right here, our model, it's my sixth grader, Hannah. Okay, if you look at that, she's standing and her head is sort of drooping down and her shoulders are slouched. That would be what we call bad posture. On the second picture, There's another way that a singer can have poor posture, and that is by not having a straight line in your lower back. And if you look at the illustration, you will see that the person has locked knees. That means they're locked straight. And what that does, if you lock your knees, it will make the lower part of your back sway back. And the reason that's bad for singing is what it does is it will stretch out abdominal muscles in the front so they can't expand. And you'll understand why when we talk about breathing. Now we see an illustration of perfect standing posture for singing. The first thing at the top, you see that her head is level. It's not reaching up, it's not slouching forward or reaching down. Sometimes when people sing, they will reach up with their heads when they're singing high notes, and they'll reach down with their heads, scrunch them down when they're singing low notes. Now, that is the wrong thing to do. You need to keep your head level all the time because if you, you know, you need to keep your neck in position so you're not messing with your vocal cords. Secondly, you can see that our model here, her chest is high. And the way to, I mean, it's sort of like getting the old bodybuilder Arnold Schwarzenegger look. Okay? The best way to feel this is imagine there is a string tied to your sternum, and then you pull up on it. Okay, so chest high, then look around to the back, and you see that her shoulders are back and relaxed. That's part of having your chest high, shoulders back and relaxed. Another thing that you can do to make yourself feel this kind of a straight lift is take a hair at the very top of your head, you know, provided you have hairs there. But anyway, well, most of you, you're all young probably, so you do, but, or imagine that you have a hair at the top of your head and you just pull straight up on that. Okay? And just in a relaxed manner, just align yourself with that. And you should have your head level, chest high, shoulders back, and relaxed when you do that. The other part of your posture that's very important to give attention to is, once again, your lower back. Your lower back should be straight. And the way it can become straight is if you have a slight bend in your knees. Now, this isn't like it's bent so it's visible, but our model here, she has just so her knees are not locked, but that gives you the ability to have a straight lower back. Now, if you lie down flat on your back and then you bend your knees up, you see, then you will feel your entire back laying flat on the floor. Now, if you put your legs straight down, then you're going to feel that sway back that I was talking about in the other picture. So the slight bend in your knees is very important. Our last illustration is a picture of what your posture should look like when you sit. Now, you notice the model is sitting out at the edge of the chair. And that's because most chairs are not built for good singing posture. There are in existence chairs that are made especially for singers, but there's not many of those around. So the best bet is to sit at the edge of your chair. Now, do you notice that all the other same things are the same? Head level, chest high, shoulders back and relaxed, lower back straight. Okay, so the thing that gives you the ability to have a straight lower back when you sit is if you are at the edge of your chair, you have your feet on the floor, apart, and one slightly ahead of the other. And actually, you should be balanced on your feet so you could just stand right up. See, you're sitting that way, but that is what makes your lower back straight. And that will facilitate the kind of breathing we need to do for singing. This is what I want you to do this week. And actually, every week, but this week, we're only talking about posture. So just at the beginning of your class period, or, you know, I don't know what your circumstances are, if you're able to stand up, sit down, or do any of those kinds of things. But at some point when you're working on this class, be conscious of your posture. You really need to do it at home in front of the bathroom mirror, or if you have a big mirror in your bedroom, of course. But just think, head level, chest high, shoulders back and relaxed, slight bend in your knees so your lower back is straight. Okay, and then also practice sitting. So I want you to practice that every day.